Hi children, a very warm welcome to Narana Live class. So today in this session we are going to see an assignment 11 on towns, traders and craft persons. So here are 10 questions. Let us find the answers. The first question is, during which century onwards the subcontinent was emerged with several small towns? So the answer is from 8th century onwards. The first question answer is 8th century. Now let's take second question, children. What kind of market did the small towns have? The answer is Mandapika. So later it came to know as Mandi. And also market streets, which we call them as Hatta. Okay. So second question answer is what, children? Mandapika. So latter it's known as Mandi. And second one is Hatta. So what is meant by Hatta? It is a market street. Market streets. Like, so if you go T Nagar, how all shops are arranged in one street. So that is called Hatta here. Now let's take third question, children. Why so many people come to Hatta from distant places? So why they come to market? That means Hatta. Because to sell their products, like what? Horses, salt, camphor, saffron, betel nut and spices like pepper. Okay, children. So the third question answer is to sell horses, okay, camphor. So next what? To sell horses, salt, camphor, saffron, salt, saffron, betel nut and other spices like pepper. Okay, children, to sell horses, camphor, salt, saffron, betel nut and other spices like pepper. So for this reason, so they are coming to Hatta. So let's go for list of questions. Now, fourth question, children. What was the role of Samanta or Jamindar? So, the answer is they laid taxes on traders, artisans, articles of trade. So, laid taxes means impose the taxes on them. Even sometimes they donated the right to collect the taxes to local temples which they built. Okay, children, let us see the answer. So now we are going to the fourth question answer. Okay, so they levied taxes on traders. Okay, so they levied taxes on traders, artisans and articles of trade. Artisans and articles of trade. Sometimes, okay, so sometimes what they will do? So sometimes donate the right to collect tax. Sometimes donated the right to collect taxes to temples which they built. Okay, children. So they impose the taxes on traders, artisans, articles of trade, and sometimes they donate the rights to collect the taxes to temples which they built. Now let's go to fifth question. Name the spices which became a part of European cooking? So the answer is pepper, so cinnamon, nutmeg, dried ginger, etc. Okay, children. So fifth question answer is pepper, cinnamon. Okay. So then nutmeg. Right. So then dried ginger. Dried ginger, etc. Okay. Now let's move to the rest of questions. Now let's take sixth question, children. What attracted European traders to India? The answer is spices like pepper and cotton cloth. So sixth question answer is spices and cotton cloth. So why spices they attracted, you know, children? Because it's a very important part of in European cooking, and cotton cloth very much attracted to the European traders. Okay, now let's go to the seventh question. From where did Gujarati traders bring gold and ivory? The answer is from Africa. So seventh question answer is Africa. Now let's take eighth question. Name the cities that were linked to celebrate Silk Route. The answer is Kabul and Kandahar. So the eighth question answer is Kabul and Kandahar. Yeah. Now let's take ninth question, children. Who was Jean Baptiste Tavernier? So answer is he's a diamond merchant. So ninth question answer is he's a diamond merchant. Now let's take last question, 10th question, children. What is the total amount estimated by Jean Baptiste Tavernier at Kabul? The answer is 30,000 rupees annually. So 10th question answer is 30,000 rupees annually. So Krishna, so these are 10 question answers related to this assignment. I hope you are clear with these answers. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Now signing off.